A reading from the Holy Bible, New American Bible, Exodus chapter 16, the Desert of Sin. Having set out from Elim, the whole Israelite community came into the Desert of Sin, which is between Elim and Sinai, on the 15th day of the second month after their departure from the land of Egypt. Here in the desert, the whole Israelite community grumbled against Moshe and Aaron. The Israelites said to them, "Would that we had died at the Lord's hand in the land of Egypt, as we sat by our flesh pots and ate our fill of bread. But you had to lead us into this desert to make the whole community die of famine." The quail and manna. Then the Lord said to Moshe, "I will now rain down bread from heaven for you. Each day the people are to go out and gather their daily portion. Thus will I test them to see whether they follow my instructions or not. On the sixth day, however, when they prepare what they bring in, let it be twice as much as they gather on the other days." So Moshe and Aaron told all the Israelites, "At evening you will know that it was the Lord who brought you out of the land of Egypt, and in the morning you will see the glory of the Lord, as he heeds your grumbling against him. But what are we that you should grumble against us? When the Lord gives you flesh to eat in the evening," continued Moshe, "and in the morning your fill of bread, as he heeds the grumbling you utter against him, what then are we? Your grumbling is not against us, but against the Lord." Then Moshe said to Aaron, "Tell the whole Israelite community, present yourselves before the Lord, for he has heard your grumbling." When Aaron announced this to the whole Israelite community, they turned toward the desert, and lo, the glory of the Lord appeared in the cloud. The Lord spoke to Moshe and said, "I have heard the grumbling of the Israelites. Tell them, in the evening twilight you shall eat flesh, and in the morning you shall have your fill of bread, so that you may know that I, the Lord, am your God." In the evening, quail came up and covered the camp. In the morning, a dew lay all about the camp, and when the dew evaporated, there on the surface of the desert were fine flakes like hoarfrost on the ground. On seeing it, the Israelites asked one another, "What is this?" For they did not know what it was, but Moshe told them, "This is the bread which the Lord has given you to eat." Regulations regarding the manna. Now this is what the Lord has commanded. So gather it that everyone has enough to eat, an omer for each person, as many of you as there are, each man providing for those of his own tent. The Israelites did so. Some gathered a large and some a small amount. But when they measured it out by the omer, he who had gathered a large amount did not have too much, and he who had gathered a small amount did not have too little. They so gathered that everyone had enough to eat. Moshe also told them, "Let no one keep any of it over until tomorrow morning." But they would not listen to him. When some kept a part of it over until the following morning, it became wormy and rotten. Therefore, Moshe was displeased with them. Morning after morning, they gathered it, till each had enough to eat. But when the sun grew hot, the manna melted away. On the sixth day, they gathered twice as much food, two omers for each person. When all the leaders of the community came and reported this to Moshe, he told them, "This is what the Lord prescribed. Tomorrow is a day of complete rest, the Sabbath, sacred to the Lord. You may either bake or boil the manna, as you please, but whatever is left, put away and keep for the morrow." When they put it away for the morrow, as Moshe commanded, it did not become rotten or wormy. Moshe then said, eat it today, for today is the Sabbath of the Lord. On this day you will not find any of it on the ground. On the other 6 days you can gather it, but on the seventh day, the Sabbath, none of it will be there. Still, on the seventh day, some of the people went out to gather it, although they did not find any. Then the Lord said to Moshe, how long will you refuse to keep my commandments and laws? Take note, the Lord has given you the Sabbath. That is why on the sixth day, he gives you food for 2 days. On the seventh day, everyone is to stay home, and no one is to go out. After that, the people rested on the seventh day. The Israelites called this food manna. It was like coriander seed, but white, and it tasted like wafers made with honey. Moshe said, this is what the Lord has commanded. Keep an omer full of manna for your descendants, that they may see what food I gave you to eat in the desert when I brought you out of the land of Egypt. Moshe then told Aaron, take an urn and put an omer of manna in it. Then place it before the Lord in safekeeping for your descendants. So Aaron placed it in front of the commandments for safekeeping, as the Lord had commanded Moshe. The Israelites ate this manna for 40 years until they came to settled land. They ate manna until they reached the borders of Canaan. An omer is 1/10 of an ephah.